Okay, ladies and gentlemen, before this video starts, because we're gonna go over these clan season 4 changelog, before this video starts, you guys don't have to ask on which server ClanYT is gonna be playing. Just join the Discord. Like, if you haven't joined the ClanYT Discord, I don't know what you're doing with your life, because everything you wanna know about clans, about Minecraft, about everything, Mineplex related stuff, just join the ClanYT Discord, because we got Mineplex clans mods, we got developers, we got YT ranks, YouTube ranks, we got everyone in the ClanYT Discord. So you just want to join, you get like announcements and all sorts of stuff, and you know when clans live streams happen or clans videos or just videos in general, because of all the ClanYT members in the ClanYT Discord. We got almost 1,000 members, so if you haven't joined yet, you should definitely join. Links in the description together with my Discord, my personal Discord, which I use for uploads and stuff. So yeah, but let's go over the clans season 4 changelog, because we got a boatload of stuff. Now I just want to quickly just go over it, not skip the introduction. We'll start with rearranging hardcore and casual servers, because as you guys all know, we have hardcore and casual servers. And before, we had casual servers on our season 3. The casual servers were, I think, 1, 2, 3, and... No, not 4. 1, 2, and 3. Yeah. And now, the casual servers will be... Wait, I got a little list up here. Okay. Casual servers are Clans 7, Clans 8, Clans 9, and Clans 102 for the Euro players. Hardcore servers will be Clans 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 10 and 11 if needed. I don't know if it's going to be necessary, to be honest. Probably, like, at the start of clans, it might look like we need extra clan servers, but midway through the season, when people stop playing the game, there might be, well, it might not be necessary anymore. And, yeah, also, clans 101 will be a hardcore server for Europe. So, that means there's only two servers on Europe, Mineplex, actually, clans 101 and 102. So, yeah, that's pretty much the hardcore and casual servers. Now the server clan, which you will be playing on, you will see soon enough. Or just join Discord, because I think it got announced in there. So yeah! Next up, we got some queues. Well, you guys have all seen the queue, so you can join. You just click the clan's NPC and you get put into a queue. So as it says over here, anyone with a premium rank will be given priority access and automatically pass any non-premium players waiting in the queue. Which is neat, because I'm Eternal, I guess. I mean, it's something. I just want YT so I don't have a queue. But hey, one day, perhaps. So next up, we got some bug fixes and improvements. Now, normally, in a regular update, these are not that neat, I guess. But now, they are actually pretty useful, because we got a ton of issues fixed and a ton of just useful things that you want to know that are fixed. Such as flash glitching through walls and certain blocks, blinking through certain walls and blocks, passing through walls and certain blocks using mounts, using skills from assorted classes, being able to fly with magnetic mauler mounts, which was pretty funny. Sand and gravel could be duplicated with fissure, that got fixed. Lightning orb duplication is fixed. Remain invisible with illusion and remain invisible with smoke bomb are fixed. So that's why they're returning, because I think Alex is the only clans developer, so he probably fixed it. Good job, Alex. We all love you. Okay. Fixed an issue where players could use bows and bow skills from horseback. That's gonna be great. Fixed an issue where mounts could not jump if equipped with skins. I never really had that issue, because I just had a standard garbage horse. They fixed an issue where old silver tokens wouldn't be consumed when entering the Child's Withertongue raid, which is always neat, because people just got to the point where they had like 200 tokens and it just wasn't fun. And they fixed a bunch of other stuff in the Witherton raid, such as skipping rooms, trapping Charles Witherton in Ice Prison, and they fixed an issue where Sight of the Fallen Lord healed too rapidly. They reduced the drop rate of the Fallen Lord, they reduced the drop rate of the Sight. They added additional contents to improve loot from Carl's Witherton raid. Charles, not Carl's, and Gianto, you're dumb. Okay, they improved the loot from Charles Witherton, or they added additional content. I'm confused. Okay, don't worry about it. You can read it for yourselves, ladies and gentlemen. And they fixed an issue where the beginning of World's PvP timer wasn't working. So those are all the bug fixes. It's a lot, I know, but we got a lot more stuff. I'll just quickly go over those, because like the bug fixes just took a while, okay? So, Undead cities are gonna be back, and they will be stationary. So when you beat the event, it won't disappear, it will just like, I think only the mobs and the chests and furnaces will be gone. And that's the only thing that will change. So yeah, it's gonna be back, ladies and gentlemen, which is neat. I mean, if you think about it, solo clans, and just when you're all on your own on the server, you can easily go to one of these cities, because I, like, back in beta and alpha, I always used to do that, and I got so many legendaries, so many rare stuff, so many gear. Wait, so many gear? English. So much gear, just because of these undead cities. So they're just great, because you can go over there all on your own instead of going to a boss and having a big chance of dying. And it takes forever. So, and it's not fun. I mean, fighting bosses is not fun. Now, they also re-implemented King of the Hill, which is pretty neat, because I don't think I've ever played King of the Hill, because back in alpha I had a solo clan, so I never really went to a King of the Hill. So it has been simplified. You just gotta get a clan, stand on a point for 5 minutes, and you get loot. That's pretty much it. And it will randomly spawn, I assume, just like the boss and in that cities. Now, they re-implemented smoke bombing illusion, already went over that. They improved die boxes. So in season 3 we had die boxes, I think they gave 6 and 9. And, or it was 6 to 9, yeah, I think it was 6 to 9. And now it's 32 to 64, I think, or 32 and 64. I think there's only one box, right? So we got 32 to 64, which is a pretty big improvement, I guess. I don't know if it's still worth the money, because it's purely aesthetic. Well, all of my Plexus purchasable items are pretty much aesthetically, or... yeah, well, you know what I'm saying. Okay, so they added boss summon tokens, which is pretty neat. You can get the tokens online, but I think they are also a drop from, like, bosses or events, and yeah, I don't know. But yeah, you can just resummon bosses and it will just summon in a random arena, I think. I don't know how it works, but we'll see. And everyone can fight those bosses, so if you summon a boss, be careful, because everyone can fight them. Now, they added supply drops. I don't know if these are in-game things that you can find, or if they are only purchasable through the online shop, but it's pretty much a supply drop. It will spawn at fields, take 2 minutes to come down, and anyone can loot it, and it has, like, legendaries and rare stuff in it, I think. Now, we also got a little minor change. They dropped support for 1.9, 1.10, and 1.11. I don't think anyone played on those versions anyway, so it doesn't matter. So you can still play clans through the versions 1.8 through 1.9, wait, not 1.9, 1.8 through 1.8.9, and 1.12 and higher. Those are the only versions you can play clans on, I think. So yeah, and last but not least, it's pretty dope, VPN blocking and IP banning. Which means, well, this is actually a pretty big change. There's no more alting, unless people will find ways to bypass, which I think people already are finding ways to bypass, and everyone in Clan with Discord is going crazy about how to bypass the VPN blocking. So basically, if you log on with an account, and you log on another account with this, on the same IP, so just pretty much on the same computer, I think both accounts will be banned or something. I don't know how it exactly works. You can read this for yourselves, and there's, like, a little forum post, I think, about it and everything. So you can read it for yourselves, but pretty much comes down to alting being gone. That's the thing. Don't worry about it. Like, if you have siblings in your house that both play, and you both play Mineplex, you can, like, I think, report and get a ticket so you can both play on the same IP. So don't worry, ladies and gentlemen, it's just to prevent alters from alting, which is, I guess, pretty neat. So yeah, as an extra little update, the new legendary, the Lance, is not in a changelog, because it will, I think, be added midway through season 4, so get your hopes up. I think it's coming soon, I don't know when, like, everyone is saying midway through season 4, so yeah, you guys just gotta wait for that, I guess. Those are all the changes. I've been rambling on for like 10 minutes, so I hope you all enjoyed, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you're all hyped for Clan Season 4 with Clan YT. It's gonna be neat. And yeah, be sure to join the Clan YT Discord, be sure to join my Discord, follow me on Twitter, follow me on Twitch. I will see you folks in my next video. Bye bye.